Rebuilding a Grant City is not your cut it.
So lucky you.
Yes,
I don't know what that is.
This is some kind of really.
Is it?
Yes.
That's Grant City.
Yes.
It probably won't work though.
So we're doing like
only
that.
Two holes.
You are doing.
Are we actually physically building it?
Correct.
It doesn't have the ground.
Like you are. Yes.
Right.
If that's what you've chosen.
Holes.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh. It's just so whatever you use.
Correct.
Okay.
Oh, thank you, Gracie.
Awesome. Daniel, you did things that were right in your farm, except you didn't go in your design far enough. You didn't tell me what parts of the organelles match up with the farm parts. You did it on the chart, but you didn't do it on the map that you
drew.
Oh,
that's all I do.
Correct. And then you
have
to go
based
on
scale.
Yes, and scale.
Yeah.
Have you looked at the rubric?
Yeah.
Awesome.
I did that before I called you in frustration yesterday.
That one has like 3 foot.
There it is.
This is my surprise. I didn't drive.
Mister, did you want to start or did Heather want to start?
I don't know. We're having internet connection issues.
We're having internet issues? Grab your laptop and grab a seat. We need to find you a chair. Yeah.
So don't bounce.
Brooklyn, don't build anything just yet.
They
let us look at your design first. Just so that we don't have to do something that is right. Yeah, just to go ahead. No, my bad.
One of the reasons we push the design is so that you don't get started down the wrong path and then have to stop and redo everything.
Because that would suck.
Yes.
I mean, every time a teacher corrects you, if you had to stop and redo 4 hours of work, you'd be awful upset. So do a good job on your design. Make sure that your design has been approved, and then go to work. There were several questions that were asked that should probably be addressed as a group. Right?
Yeah, sure.
What were those questions? Who wants to start?
Meaning of life.
What is love?
One.
It means dying.
That's funny. All right. You people all suck. You've got questions.
Yeah, but we answered some.
The official scientific meaning of healthy is you're just dying slower than everybody else?
Yeah.
No, you're dying at the same rate as another healthy person.
Dying slower than everybody else because healthy is a comparative term. You're comparing to unhealthy, and unhealthy is dying faster than everybody else.
What if you're healthy?
Because we're all close to diet.
You must focus, Mr. Snyder.
Our question from Daniel was, because Daniel said something and then Erica and some of the girls didn't like what Daniel
said.
We were
arguing outside the hall.
I guess what we didn't know is if we were comparing it to something, like if we were, or actually like physically building it.
Young people, what's the definition of an analogy?
I have an idea, girl. I can't know it.
Huh?
You're comparing something to another.
Exactly. So here's the deal. When you guys all looked at the cell analogy chart, did any of you bother to figure out what analogy meant to begin with?
No. Nope.
Yeah.
I watched the movie and it was in there.
And so in the design and the build, when it said you're creating an analogy of a cell, you're building a model of a cell, an analogy, did you figure out what that meant?
Yeah.
Awesome. So then there would have been no argument.
Yeah, but we still argue.
Why? Because
they said I was wrong.
Well,
oh my goodness. You're wrong at least.
And you know what's going to happen every time you say Daniel's wrong.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There's going to be something.
Because listen, you're not building us a cell. Cells are out there. We can go find a model of a cell. We can build a cell. We can do all this stuff. Hey, you just listen to everything I say. Don't stop me halfway. Hang on just a minute. I do it quietly. Okay. So here's the deal with that. You're not just going to do a cell. You're not just going to go draw a cell. There's no challenge there. You guys could just go to the web and trace it. Lord have mercy. What have you done? You've done nothing. Right. You have to find something that is in existence in the world that you can compare that cell to, which is why we started with Grant City. Grant City was an analogy of a cell. Exactly. So when you're designing a model of an analogy of a cell, that's what you do. So you're going to give us a cell, but it's an analogy of a cell. So, and I'll give you some examples here, all right? He's doing a
bird. Yeah, go ahead. They've all got, have you all got ideas already?
Not
really. Do you want me to move, kiddo? All right. Do you all have ideas?
No, not yet.
If we, you have stuff here, you don't have an idea?
Well, I thought we were making a model, not like.
Well, hang on, but we can help you fix that.
That can be modified in any way.
Exactly. I have a really good idea already.
Let's eat it.
You sit. No, we can't eat. You sit for a second while we're talking.
I can eat anything.
Yep. So, do we share or do we not share?
I don't know. I'm torn.
I'm torn too.
We should share.
If we share, I don't want somebody else then to steal that idea.
Yeah,
and if they have another idea on their own, then I'm torn with that too. Can we share yours?
Yeah.
All right, we'll share Daniel since Daniel was like, you know, thrown at.
Well, everybody's already known.
That's okay. Well, so Daniel's doing a farm.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. How is a farm an analogy of a cell? You would start by saying a farm is like a cell because, right?
Yeah.
Is that how the Grant City thing started out?
Yeah.
A city is like a cell because, and then they explain why or how?
Correct.
Yeah. So that's pretty much all.
That's pretty much what you're doing.
And here's what we're asking you to do. We're asking you guys to pick something for which you are familiar.
Yes.
Choose something that you can then say, holy cow, I've lived all my life. I didn't know that was just like a cell.
Holy biscuits.
There you go.
And
so
gravy.
That's,
no,
there you
biscuits.
Go.
Just gravy,
so that's
gravy,
what you need
tomorrow.
To do. So your design is what it is that you're doing. Your build is the model of that. I hate to tell you all this, but that's exactly what's written in the directions.
Hey, Bis.
Yeah, but
so,
yeah.
If you had read the directions a little more carefully, would you have known exactly what you know now?
Probably not.
I still would
probably know. Wait a second. Then, at this moment, you should go back to the directions and see if you can read those directions and see if you get the same things in your head that you just got when we talked out loud.
So, the directions are in, like,
the PDF.
Yeah. That one.
It's
whatever that
is. It's spellcitychallenge.com.
Yeah.
Go back to that. Read those directions and see if the same thing comes into your brain as what you just got from our oral conversation. Yeah. There's two things that can happen. And we want to wait and let everybody have time to find it and read it and contemplate. Because either the directions were well written and you're okay. And you did a crappy job of figuring them out. Or the directions were poorly written. And it was very difficult for you to figure them out. Which one was it?
The latter.
In kind of in the middle.
You just interpreted it wrong.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Now, knowing what you know, and being an intelligent sophomore, and having the class that we had, and then you were given this, should you have been able to figure it out?
Yeah.
No one said anything about intelligence.
Wait a second. And how many times have you done this exact same thing that I just asked you to do?
Every single time we get in a serious situation.
When you get directions from us, you have to do this, right?
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever done it before? Did you do it in fifth grade? Did you do it in third grade? I got instructions. Oh, crap. I need to figure out what I need to do here. What do I already know? What have we talked about today in class? Now when I look at those directions, oh yeah, now I know exactly what to do. Or you have to ask another question. And either way the deal is, they're redoing their building over there, and their internet is iffy at best. Okay? So this part
part of the conversation is simply about directions and applying what you already know. Applying what's going on in class to the directions and figuring out what you need to do. It's an academic exercise. It's something that you need to be able to do, because for the rest of your life, people are going to be telling you to do stuff, and they're not going to give you every single step and every single thing you need to do in order to get it done.
Which leads us to Super Plant, or have you been there?
No, I haven't been to Super Plant yet.
Heather, do you want to talk about Super Plant?
She's frozen.
Is she frozen? She looks frozen. Nope, there she moved.
There she moved.
This is really fun. I'm about to get a hot spot, I hope, and then I'll be able to connect individually.
Ooh,
and
awesome.
Be better. But yeah, I really want to talk to you guys about Super Plants and show some examples. I know grades are low. Please don't freak out. You can totally resubmit that stuff. We're in the evaluation process. This is not your final product. So please check out my comments on there. And I'll do my talk as soon as we know the internet's being more reliable. Otherwise, I think I'm going to get cut off in the middle of it.
Okay.
But from what I did see, you guys did a good job. You just weren't addressing everything that needed to be there. So again, look at my comments, resubmit if you'd like, and we'll chat later this class period too.
Cool.
Looked at also five, maybe six of them, and I agreed completely with Heather's comments and her grades. I couldn't find anything that I wanted to change or modify as far as the scores that she gave you or the comments that she gave you.
And I, yeah.
If you disagree with the grade that you're given, please always question us, ask us why, after you do what I just asked you to do while Mary was out of the room. Stop and think about what we did in class. Stop and think about the directions. Stop and think about what you did. If you can figure it out on your own, you're better off. If you can't figure it out on your own, we want to help. Please ask.
Which is why it's so important, and I keep going back with that one question when you ask me a question about your design and your build. Have you looked at the rubric? Have you looked at what's going to get you the most possible points in any situation?
And then did you just glance at the rubric and then do some junk? Or did you look at the rubric, read it carefully, think about what's going on in class, and do everything you can to get all those points? Almost always the answer is no to that.
Designs need to be looked at. I've looked at a couple, and they're ready to start building. So we've got, you know, three of us here. You can chat with any of us. We'll look at your designs. We'll look at yours. You're good to go. I've looked at yours.
Suckers.
And you were going to help me modify to fit that requirement.
What did I do?
And she didn't say she.
But she did. She got here. Yeah, she got here right as the party bell was ringing. All of those recordings.
That's fair.
Do you know why she reassigned? I know, but do you know why she reassigned?
Yeah.
Because she didn't hear you. She heard. Now listen. I've been doing this a long time. She could hear background noise. So she knows the recording.
It's in here.
Yep.
I want to go home.
Nice. So, Miss Page, when you do your recordings, you must use a mic. Or you're going to have to find your Mrs. Schneider voice.
Okay. All right. About Spanish?
Yes.
What was the issue with Page's
stuff?
She could hear the background noise, but she couldn't hear Page.
Mrs. Bitterman may have a headset.
They do. They have headsets with mics for Spanish.
No, actually, it's all. Okay, so.
Oh! Hi! How are you? Do you have a design?
Can you look at my design?
Well, I have one in my bed that's not.
I have. Oh, interesting.
Okay, that's not just in here. And you can attest to this, right? Designs we like to do out before we build so that we don't build wrong. So we want to do that design, but do you know what that looks like? And not even thinking that it's a cell, what it looks like to me? It looks like a kid's playground.
Well, it's
like an amusement park, huh?
Yeah.
That's kind of where I went with that.
Amusement park.
Yeah, amusement park, something like that.
Mrs.
That can be your analogy. That would be your build, but we need you to go back and do that design, because that analogy chart and everything.
So I fill out the analogy chart first.
Fill out the analogy chart. Analogy chart two, because that's going to dictate what your stuff is, how it's going to look, and what part of the organelle it is, and how it's acting is that. Yes, Daniel, you did it right.
And are we going to accept sketch a drawing as a final product.
So what do you mean, what would the structure look like? Hey, just need to put a picture of the cell?
What would it look like? And you can, again, if you're going to put a picture, yeah, it's going to be
a picture of that sticking in there.
Or she could just describe it.
Or you could draw it.
You could draw it, you could describe it.
That's just painting.
Okay, but what about the one before the Grant City one?
We'll need it.
What is that? You just put down something like, looks like a post office?
No, it's what the part of the cell looks like.
That's the literal cell.
Right. You know what? I don't have a problem with the drawing. What I have a problem with is, and again, I'll pick on Daniel here.
No, don't pick on Daniel.
Yeah, let me see your live notebook. This is not a drawing. For a final project.
Oh, no.
What if we had color?
Wait, is that on the right
side? What if we had color?
He's okay.
That was just an example.
I know.
Gee, Willikers, chill out,
bro.
Thank you.
If you're going to submit a drawing,
right.
We need a scientific drawing. We need an actual drawing. We need, like, straight lines to be actually straight. We need 90-degree corners.
Because remember, you have a proportion element to this
as
well.
Yes, you do.
Your cell analogy model has to be proportional, which means you can't have a cell wall that is tinier than the nucleus.
That makes perfect sense.
And I have no idea if this is correct. I think it's probably wrong. That's why I'm picking it. Okay?
Oh my goodness.
If a nucleus is half as large as a mitochondria, you look them up, you find the actual size, and one of them is exactly twice as big as the other. You can't use these two things to make one a nucleus and one a mitochondria, because they're not twice as big as the other. You have to find something that's actually twice as big, if they're supposed to be twice as big.
And you're sitting there wondering, how are you going to do that when you're playing
for
a team, right? But if you look at your basketball team,
you're
all the same size.
Yeah, well, I don't have the
question.
So, like, technically,
I have a
team.
Question. I have a question.
Oh, no.
What's
this
going to
do
to
us?
Okay. Hang on a second. Trevor, ask the question first.
Well, again, look at those measurements, right?
No.
Yeah.
So, and go from there.
I'm in the same boat as you.
I have a question.
Yeah, so the back of this one, we're making a plant cell, right?
Correct.
And lysosomes are only in animals.
Right.
Or is your
whole
Hang on a minute here. Those of you who are having a hard time coming up with an idea of something that it is that you want to make the analogy of, what do you like to do? See, I'm going to pick on Haley here for just a second, because Haley's looking at a model of a cell.
Yeah, but now we can't do that.
Correct. But the minute she did that, she took away her creative value. And all of a sudden she started comparing, well, I can't do that. That's not going to look nearly as well. I can't do that because I can't do that. And this isn't what,
Don't go there.
Think about those things that it could be. I'll be honest with you. Oh, I have such a good idea. A refrigerator.
I call a refrigerator.
Think about those things in your life that are just around you, that act as a cell, but in a different way. So you're not going to have an actual nucleus, but you have something that acts as the nucleus.
What's the function of the nucleus?
Power.
No, that's my mitochondria.
It's a control center of the cell.
So it's got like plans for making all the parts?
Yes.
It's got like instructions and directions.
It'd be like this.
So if I was an army, it would be the general.
Yes.
If I was a college, it would be the
professor.
Dean's office. If I was a town, it would be the city hall. If I was a county, it would be the.
There's only one thing that I'm going back. That's
county
totally
courthouse. If I was a country, it would be. I could do like seven more in like the next minute.
Oh, what's it on? What do you have on? No, I know that. What are you working with it on? Make a note. What are you going to change it?
Since I haven't designed yet,
I was going to make a design.
Yes.
cell.
Your idea.
I don't care.
Yes.
If your hog barn is 5 times the size of your hay store,
right, so your modification,
as long as the
right
function,
now, what is this going to be your
in a cell, is the same
as
the function on the farm.
So if you
as long as the proportion in the cell is the same as the proportion on the farm,
then
even
then
if that makes the farm not work.
You
need to use the cell as your scale, not the farm.
You're getting an idea?
Yeah.
Can I really use
refrigerators?
As long as you can get all the functions of the cell into
so
that
you try
space,
to get down and then we'll work on
the then yeah, I got most of them.
But
yeah,
if you get down, then we'll work on
even if you have to modify it, then
I would,
this way,
to be honest with you, my designs are almost always drawn.
Mr. Schneider,
not a refrigerator. Can
you, like,
yes.
Can I go get that, Mr. Schneider?
You can do your whole house with that. That's a lot.
Why would you
need
it here right now today?
Because, well, I had this idea last night,
and
my mom threw away my shoebox that I had an idea with.
Ah, losing
at 12.
So
just let us know what you're
doing.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh,
yes. But now, if I had that shoebox, I could do it. I don't know.
Yeah.
All right. Stop, Mark.
Where's your set?
No,
I
can't.
Everybody.
Okay, you have a few problems in your design that you don't have things matched up to what the organelle is.
I don't understand these numbers.
So power means what?
I went and looked up all the numbers, how big these things are. They don't make any dang sense to me. Now what?
So that's what's going to happen.
So
you get to do all of that.
Just,
and you need to use
Google it and make it.
Make it till you make
it.
Did you look up the metric system prefixes like I asked you to?
Yeah.
Did you come up with something that looks like a goofy B?
Yeah.
Like half of an hourglass?
I still got
a huge list.
Yeah. But it's going to, when you look at how wide those numbers are, like Trevor's, they're really huge numbers here, and they come down to one. And then they go out to really huge numbers down below one again. So the bigger the thing is, the bigger the number is. And it gets smaller, smaller, smaller until you get to one. And then when you get smaller than one, the farther below one you get, the bigger the number gets because it's a decimal and it's got like more zeros before the one. Does that make sense? You need to figure out that one little thing that we talked about for like 14 seconds last time, Tuesday. If something is a times 10 to the third, and the next one is times 10 to the fourth, how much difference is that?
Zero.
1, 0, which is 10 times bigger or smaller.
Yeah.
Right? Because you go from 1 to 10, so it's 10 times bigger.
Yeah.
You go from 10 to 100, it's 10 times bigger. You go from 100 to 1,000, it's 10 times bigger. From 1 to 1,000, it's 1,000 times bigger. How many zeros is that?
Three.
So if you're looking at exponents, and you have 10 to the third and 10 to the sixth,
they're 3,000
times bigger.
Smaller.
Well, if you go below zero, it's smaller. If you go above zero, it's bigger. Okay? That's the answer to the question that you asked me. You have to understand all of those stupid little abbreviations. What's that funky little thing that looks like a U with an extra line on the left side of it?
Micrometer.
Micrometer, which means?
Tiny meters.
3 zeros under.
Isabel.
Micro is.
What?
Isabel?
What?
1/1,000 if you make it a fraction?
Okay. I'm going to yell at you.
Yeah.
No. What's 1/1,000?
Oh, you and Matt.
It's metric system. It's plain, simple metric system. Trevor, what's the one that has 1/1,000 next to it?
1/1,000.
Yours doesn't have fractions, does it?
Nope.
Use the decimals. What's 1/1,000 as a decimal? As 0.001.
Yeah,
it's milli.
It's a
milli. Milli is the same thing as 1/1,000. So you have to have 1,000 millimeters to make a meter. We go from milli to micro. And a micrometer or micrometer, if you're in England, is. And what's the difference between 1,000 and a million? 3 zeros, right? So it's 1,000 times different. And if we go from micro to nano, and then nano to pico,
Did you get your assignments from me this?
And can I see anybody's computer while I'm doing this?
No.
You need to be familiar enough that you can go back and look at it and go, oh yeah, I got it.
Yeah.
This one's 1,000 times, this one's 100,000 times, this one's 1,000,000 times. You gotta be able to compare those.
What the hell do you
U and M, what's the M?
Meter.
Could it be a U and a capital L?
Meter, that's
it'd be microliter.
Because U and M is micrometer, N M is nanometer.
Yeah.
Where do you start?
Okay,
it's really simple. After you understand the numbers, it's really simple.
Absolutely.
The first one is.
No.
What?
Where do you start? Brainstorm first or you design first?
All of these can have a leader behind them. All of these can have a leader behind them. So you can have.
And you have specific things that you have to do for the brainstorm.
What if I.
Mega meter.
What if you what?
You can
what if
have
you lose your weight the next 20 seconds?
M, that's
that'd be cool.
And in the things that you're doing, they'll all have it. Even if they leave the M off, the M is implied.
I don't know what they're doing here. They walk by the
behind
people.
It's
micrometers. Remember, you are doing a plant cell. You are not doing an animal cell.
Six
plant.
Micrometers by
not animal.
One.
So you have to start with
your two different dimensions.
And if you looked at all five of those in here, you know
so
that some
can I use this one
scale four.
One this one has
right.
Oh, you haven't started. Well, I don't even
what
have
what
all
the pictures.
What are you
doing? Doing the same darn thing. Drawing a scale model. Okay.
Mrs. Snyder,
so that's going to make you.
But they're all analogies.
We're on that right now.
Mrs.
Snyder, really
it's completely hard out. But that's going to dictate how big your final product is. What I would do is find out which thing is biggest. And then figure out what the scale factor is, how big would that make it? Because if the thing is big, you're going to be wrong.
What do you know?
Well, if it makes it bigger, how big is it? That's probably not going to be wrong. So I would find the biggest thing and figure out how that works.
How did you know?
Gosh,
think
Marvel
comics.
So, like,
DC comics.
No,
which
one
is
just
do
Marvel
universe.
You
might
want
to just put
Parker.
All those in the
spreadsheet.
That's impossible. And
that's impossible.
They have the same length. Change the length.
Just
the
writers of it.
Are they already micro?
Yeah.
So they're all already micro.
Yeah.
So then you don't have to worry about fighting.
Gracie did micro.
I think that's talking about two things. One, this way, and three, that way.
What? I'm
all right. Yeah, that's okay.
What's the joke here?
That's actually not you. You should really say my name. To be but this one here,
no.
And 7
just look it up.
Would be.
Look it up on your computer.
I don't know the answer to that. I'm asking
the
question.
Nano is 9, micro is 6,
so
they're much smaller than 1,000.
So what happens if you need
all
the
different ones? Is it still the same spot as last time?
Right, but that makes you do all the
well, my sister, my dad,
so what
my brother,
you just do research.
I was
in
there.
So they need to for a cell structure to scale.
Black burger. We get there. Walk up to the door. We're sorry for the inconvenience. We're no longer selling the Halloween Whopper. Walked away.
Yeah,
McDonald's.
Yeah, they are not the Halloween Whopper anymore.
When we went to Breaking, they
had
us pissed.
Why?
So I flipped the sign off and
I
walked across the street.
I flipped. I was like, what the heck? You're not
selling
anymore.
It's probably because the attorney can just spend
the
two things.
Oh, yeah, everybody complained about it.
I don't really care.
So
I want to
only
get
you two things. Everyone, you
want
to
win.
I want
to
be great and good
burger.
So
down here,
it was 100%
worth
it. And I happen to know that that's
not.
You can find
it. I just wanted to be able to say, I see and see that in relationship
to
whatever
the
session
is,
that's as big as it is. That's actually kind of a cool visual.
But I've seen
it. Can you find
it? I saw it on America's computer.
That's just bringing it closer so that you can see how it works. So that you can see how it is in relationship too. Yeah. See, like back it all out again. See, now you can see that exactly. Wow. That is a really great website. Haley, I live to walk over here.
Where things go.
Mrs. Schneider, I move it like diapers.
Isabel, you need earplugs so your brain doesn't leak out?
I don't know.
You need earplugs so your brain doesn't leak out?
Just tell me what you're doing. Have a decision. This is where you have to get off that fence.
You have
to make a decision. I know.
She's scared to get off.
She is
scared
to get off.
She was afraid of being shocked by that. It's true.
They hurt.
Good.
Okay, I got it. That's why the design is so crucial in that world, because you can screw it up.
It has the bar on the left side.
I have an idea, but I don't
know. It's not supposed to be.
You have to design it first.
So, one second, let me draw this picture.
What are you building? What's your analogy?
That's neat.
You start with a U.
No.
It has this on the other side. And this one's supposed to be longer than this one.
So I was thinking,
and he's going to, you know, to show all the parts of the farm as they act.
Yes,
that's
the
upshake.
Yeah.
So could I do like... That's a micrometer. That means 10 to the minus 6. That's a 1 over...
Now he's getting
it. Air intake.
A million? Young people, in the city,
killing Mrs. Schneider.
In the South City analogy chart 2, it says on the top, what part of a city has a similar function as the organelle? That should not say city.
Right, remember we talked about that the other day.
That should say what part of your model.
Model.
Yeah,
I don't remember if you were asked to do a plant cell.
Yeah.
They are doing a plant cell, not a plant cell.
Yes, and yes.
So just
leave
that.
Yep.
So, like in this, when he says, what would the structure look like for the second one, would we put what the cell, or
what
the second cell, or what
it
are?
Okay.
No.
Go.
Your analogy.
Yeah.
This one's all about your analogy, not the cell. It's based on the cell, but you need to tell us about your analogy.
Mr. Schneider,
Sometimes you can find the right joke.
Did you find scale or what?
You get good at finding the right joke.
Did you find scale?
Wipe the teaser over.
Stuff gets a lot easier when you get a real home scale.
It does.
Hey, did you find
scale? Yeah. For my scale, I'm doing
like old
one micrometer equals... one
actually older than my
equals, like,
Mr. Schneider,
3 feet or something.
I'm going to get pierced with this.
And then the second one says, what would the structure look like? Can you describe what it would look like?
I did some of this.
Like on the model right here?
Correct.
Yeah,
so it's the brown.
Company itself.
The ball?
That looks like a brown turd. Okay. So when I'm doing my design, my scale is going to be like one micrometer.
We got race 3 or something.
then am I drawing? I want like one.
Sure, two.
I'll draw
to
like every micrometer.
No,
micrometer
no,
will be like every 3 feet is 1 inch. How do I rate that as a scale?
You have a scale from the cell to
the actual size,
the form to the real form. And then you also have a scale from the real form to your paper. So you have two scales.
But they're of course not.
Yeah.
Oh,
yep.
Or should I just go instead of two scales, should I just go one micrometer?
Daniel, what do you think you should do?
I don't know.
Because I know, but you're asking.
You're asking me to solve your problem instead of you solving your problem. Is there a way that you can do that with one scale and a sentence that explains what you're doing?
And just ignore the real form size.
Question mark.
Ignore the real farm size.
Is that a question mark or a statement?
It's both.
No.
Can you ignore the real farm size?
I don't know, but I can. It depends on what you want for the assignment.
Daniel, you have the rubric.
Depends on what you're going to do.
Snyder!
In order to comply with the request.
I know how to manipulate him.
Good job.
I think she does. She forgets about capitulation.
That's true.
She makes me want to get her.
Sometimes I just give up.
That's my favorite thing to say. Oh my goodness. Is that the motor upstairs?
Yeah. Someone's warmer in here than it is out there. Or something.
That's probably a vacuum.
Do you think?
This? Why do you have a little home for you? My question is how you get this to
scale
very
carefully. What? Scale. It's a snap together model that's been taken apart several times.
I love it when they finally get it. Because then it works starting.
So scale don't get it.
Yeah, you're right there, man. We just got to see it. It's right there in front of you. You just have to see it.
I know it's there, but I still can't reach it.
He doesn't want to look at it. It's a problem.
Mostly. That's true of just
about
every kid on their way in a problem-based class.
What, like,
Grand
City?
Grand
City is a piece of
paper. They're having an energy meter, they're having a mental block, they have their brain going this way, and they can't get it stopped and get it going that way.
Yeah.
Something.
Could you take a picture of that and send it to me, or scan it, or do something?
What's the important part about the discussion?
Randall, what you can do, you can say,
at the class, you actually build it.
That's what I do.
You know,
I
was going back to the scale. What's the important part about the scale?
You do.
So you build it to scale the cell.
Okay. So you have to have
to
scale the cell.
I'm not starting with that.
And you
said it's
designed
by
that's
because I know. I have something.
Instead of the scale, the phone doesn't
actually matter. Daniel, you do have a problem.
So the scale of the real cell, and one other thing matters. The scale of the real cell. You said the farm doesn't matter. What's the other thing matter? In order to have a scale, you have to have two things that you're comparing to.
I need to make steel from the tiny parts of cell.
The real thing.
They're broken.
To engineers up. Make it fit on my paper.
There you go.
Yeah.
Those two things are super important. So you can put in a sentence that explains the real farm. But the real farm doesn't exist. Because your hog barn may take up more room than your corn field.
One part is 30.
I have a question. What if
my
doesn't exactly line up with
the
cell?
There you go.
So, but again, then
sounds like you don't have a problem
anymore.
You should get a piece of scratch paper, test it out, and then
you
know.
But
you
can't make, you know,
but the,
if your cell wall is solid, you can't do
that.
You can't
solve it on my paper.
So you need
how
you need your portion.
So my part so tiny. You can sell the mod parts for like 22.
Okay.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen a diagram where one thing was not to scale and they wrote not to scale?
No, you can't.
If you make a dot on your paper and it's too big,
oh my goodness,
you can't make anything smaller than a dot. Right?
I think for Daniel that dot needs to be like to scale.
Miss Schneider,
Daniel, you have to do everything shiny pieces of dice on your farm.
Your city page numbers are incorrect. Correct.
How are they incorrect?
Tell me where the Excel city analogy chart 2 is. Tell me where your brainstorm is. See, you did so well up here, and then you screwed up.
Yeah, I got lazy and I was tired and I was mad at you.
Lazy is what you kill. Lazy kills.
I'll
so
fix that later.
That is good.
Don't do that. Don't say that, Daniel.
He thinks he has an idea.
Yeah?
He doesn't know what he's going to do with it, so maybe we can chat. Do
you have a scratch paper?
Hey, no, but you can go find some.
I'm going to make
too lazy. I don't know. I'll draw it in here.
I really like that.
It popped into my mind when you said that we had to go. Missionary, can I do
Clark?
Mr.
Yes.
Elixir,
no,
you can do
it.
Yeah.
Say no.
Daniel
can't do anything. I say no. So that means no.
Did Daniel just go to the paper?
He went to get scratch paper. Do you need him to get some more?
I think he went to get ruler.
He went to get scratch paper.
He went to get a ruler.
He told me he was
going to
go get scratch paper.
He told us he was going to get a ruler. Can I go get some scratch paper?
Yes.
There you go. Grab me some.
Okay.
Can you grab me one too,
please?
What
does that look like in
your
diagram?
No.
Are you getting
them? Are you going to draw this? Are you going to build it?
Okay, so
are you going to get
one.
Your hand?
Are
you going to use Legos?
I just want to take
that.
Jesus, this looks like
a
movie.
I think I have a chance to look like a movie.
Sorry.
Do
you
guys
want
to
but do the rest of it first and worry about size later. So just bring it for
first.
Right? So do the real world. And then
anybody that needs rulers, they're back on this desk. Well, cool, Daniel. You want to grab? Can I grab one?
You can get up and get it.
Are you the one that
effectively
just went up and asked?
No,
I'll
give you the crappy one. Yeah, here you go.
Well,
Elder, you join me. Is that scratch paper?
That works.
Can I borrow this? Thank you, Riley. I felt kind of awkward walking in as Mr. Hoke has using glasses.
So let me ask this, what's the smoothie
I
use for
that?
Parker, seriously?
Please, grab this.
That will happen.
Don't.
Yep. Oh,
probably just going to cut back.
Yeah.
That's what
you
need
to grab.
So, if you're looking at the definition,
there's
a learning process there, and you don't know what the definition is, what should you do?
Maybe I have a fever. Maybe I
you know what I
should
do?
Go home.
Smooth endoplasmic reticulum for dummies. That is literally what I would do.
Okay.
Because that is going to give me somebody who's going to redneck that definition back for me. And help me understand a little bit more. Because sometimes those science definitions are
all
science words that you have to
not
understand. And also, don't tell anybody what sentence in Wikipedia for science definitions is
the best. I don't know if I just heard that yesterday. I'm telling everyone.
I'm going to make yours
just a second. I've already
got a list.
Bill must be completed by
12. Right when you got next time.
Okay.
The rest that should be carried out.
Okay.
Bill must be completed by 12 p.m. on 29 October 2015.
So technically, it's supposed to be due today.
Yeah.
What's supposed
that's
to be
going
to
be
today?
This,
bill.
And here,
the bill.
And 15 minutes.
That ain't gonna happen today. You better make sure you have all your fingerprints. I already got that.
You're pushing away from yourself on that.
Oh, yeah.
What's the difference?
I learned my lesson the first time around.
Having a little hole in your finger is not a big deal, but springing a leak that doesn't want to stop might be.
I did that yesterday.
It depends on where it's leaking, I guess.
Is there a charger around
here? Oh, no. Is there one, Daniel?
You should have one on your laptop, Daniel.
Yeah.
Not like a charger.
Daniel. There's
like
you're
a
setup.
I don't need my computer right now. Just plug it in.
Yeah, you could just plug it in. There's like 19 of them.
I don't, yeah, but I don't know if the charger's up. Yeah.
Ms. Snow, you want to hear the title for the page that is on?
Sure.
It's Mother Truck in the
Mines. Oh, nice. All
right. Are you doing a monster truck?
No, it's just Mother Trucking. I'm fed up.
Mr. Schneider, I have a small question.
Somebody's mother is bigger than others, huh?
Yeah.
Need a truck?
Yeah.
No. Do the trick?
Oh. One time at a gas station, I saw a mother trucker. She was driving the truck with her son, like a semi truck. Yeah. What?
No, they're probably a teen.
No, I saw a mother and then a little baby kid.
Is
this
something like that, a circle like that that's a half circle?
Mr. Schneider, I have a question.
It kind of looks like a circle board. Is the mother
working?
Okay, let's bring that to the passage.
You mean you should start working on these assignments before 5 minutes?
So
you
really
go now, so
good
idea.
Yes, we got like.
So,
Seven is the biggest one. Everything you have to use the apple. And the other one.
can take it.
When you get a chance.
Yeah, I will. What part of the city has been on?
What's seven half? Okay. What you do is that everything's got to be
correct. Okay.
That was not in the instructions.
Yes, it was.
No, it's not.
Yes, it
I will prove to you. It's not instructions.
Daniel, how can you build an analogy of a cell and change the parts of the cell around?
Hey,
yeah,
they have to look in their place.
Daniel!
The cell
membranes
isn't the same.
No. It does not say anything about the
Daniel's
I might. Let me explain this here real quick first.
Like the cell wall. And then the cell membrane, the plasma gutters.
I'll be right there, Jamin. I'll be right there.
Okay.
I'll be right there.
Erica.
Animal cell.
That's what
I'm
back.
Erica.
All right. On the outside here, and then the one on the inside, the stuff.
Just to clarify, because Daniel did ask the question, yes, you're building an analogy of a cell. So if your analogy has the nucleolus existing outside of the nucleus, that can't happen. So if your nucleolus, I'm going to use Daniel's example here, he wants his nucleolus to not be inside the farmhouse, which is the nucleus, that doesn't work.
Shoot.
See, even I knew that.
Yes, but it's kind of like saying I'm going to build an analogy of a human body, but the heart doesn't really fit where the heart is in the human, so I'm going to put it in the closet.
Yes, that's what exactly
yeah.
how it works.
No. No. You don't need to take another picture. You just need the other picture.
Size to that.
Do this. Where's the initial picture you took? That one right there?
Scale.
That's the one we want you to
but
use.
It's the big
thing. Do it again? All
right, Isabel,
let's
you want some one-on-one?
We're with you all
so we have to get a very good
picture. Let's put everything else on here.
Oh, hey, I can bring Miss Kelly.
Good luck with that.
Next to you.
No.
You can get all the help.
The cell membrane is on the outside.
Have you read those?
Which two did you say?
So if I were doing cell membrane,
so do you know what you're doing now?
Yeah. I would do the code as the wall.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, you didn't move any of them around.
And then
you're already going to move
the cell membrane.
You're also going to
find
the cell
membrane
over there. Proteins.
Yeah, we're gonna have to talk to Mrs. Snyder about that because
whatever's on the chart.
You know what happens when I make decisions.
Well, yell louder, Mr. Snyder.
I am not going to entertain it yet because he asked 10 minutes into class.
Ooh.
So
it was more than 10.
That's a good thing to know.
Again, y'all.
I looked at the clock, it was more like 20. Oh, either way, it's still pretty early.
How about you just get to work, bro?
Stop making sense.
What the heck? We're students, bro.
We're
supposed to make dollars.
Dollars.
That's what.
So, I do not understand.
It looks like you're making a skyscraper or a dead tree or. This is, again, it's just a small snippet of it, right? When it's in its entirety, it'll look like something different.
It's very tiring. It takes a lot of muscle.
When you search for it, it's
properly.
Say this for Brady.
In our thing, we just
have to
make
this
law somebody thing.
Correct.
Did
you just ask that because she asked it?
So no, I was actually going to ask that. Because I start.
That's the problem. Even on here, we don't even need information.
I was worrying about nothing 20 minutes ago.
You know what, Daniel, I ask you all the time. Have you read all of your stuff? Did you look at the rubric, et cetera, et cetera?
I had.
You
I just forgot that it
had.
I had. The Schneider stuff argument.
Daniel, you started the architecture.
Like
smoothie.
The
and you're bringing mine too, so I'm sure.
Hey.
Okay,
so these are ribosomes.
Okay.
And then what is the
cold
gap
ratio?
What do you
think? Why do you think it's
better? The computer said.
It's a ribosome.
So
you don't need to take a picture, you know, you just need to
stores it.
What? I know you have 10 photos on there.
Okay.
So your mom would have to
it
out. Yeah, you can get rid of that one. Yeah, you can delete it. Yeah. Hey,
well, and you're talking about
you
the...
I'll come right back.
Both of the ERs?
We don't need to have the ribosome because it's not even in
The heater's on, the heater's
there's no need. 2 weeks.
Then they'll have heat.
Well, if only we knew it was going to get cold around Halloween in South Dakota.
It's just a fact.
I just wish somebody would have known that like a month ago so that the heat would be fixed.
And Mrs. Keller is handing out candy in Ohio. It's tonight if anybody wants to trick or treat at her house.
Round trip tickets are approximately $850.
And what did you say? It's nerds and other candies?
Wait, why are you doing that tonight where it's not even on?
Because Columbus is stupid and they are making everybody trick or treat Thursday night. They are worried that kids will get hit by crazy drivers if it's on a Friday or Saturday night.
This
so
is
they make it Thursday night because there are no crazy drivers Thursday night, right?
Okay.
It's ridiculous. I'm annoyed.
Yes. I'm with you.
Maybe she should.
When it's not supposed to be my turn,
anytime you see numbers like 15 by 20, you should probably assume that the big one is sideways. So if you're talking away from you, and this way, or up and down, and this way, the big one usually
is sideways. Is that in the center of the cell, and is it liquid?
No.
That one's close, right? That's a better guess.
He's now doing a bacterial cell.
Oh my.
So, yes, ma'am?
No.
Oh, no.
He wants you.
Check
out.
He's
I
the war. He's the god of war.
She's,
Okay. So,
but
I
make sure you understand it, right?
Yeah.
He's the best.
Because she started kind of wishy-washy.
I did, and I wanted to go home at the beginning of the
She's finally there.
So it's okay. Basketball is like a lot bigger than people. Wait, is it okay if I have things in my house that don't, like, satisfy each of these things?
No.
So I can't put anything in there that doesn't satisfy.
I think you're misunderstanding your question.
You
may not.
Can't have carpet if you don't have a cell or a mark to equate it to.
But if you don't have carpet in your house, you can share add carpet for this situation.
Because, like, I was going to ask if I could have, like, a counter, but it's not being used for anything, but there's stuff sitting on top of it.
Where's the counter? Is it, like, beside the couch in the bedroom or what?
No.
Then you could have a counter where?
In the kitchen.
There you go.
Where is
the I know, her response is kind of like, dumb, Mr. Schneider.
Yeah.
Okay, I got it.
You should get rid of anything that's in a real house that doesn't have.
Make more sense? It is a captive audience.
You don't have to have everything that's in a real house. You have to have everything that's in a real cell.
Okay. You don't have to have like everything.
Wait till we cut things up this year.
Nope. You have to have every single thing in real cell.
So you don't have to have a TV in the room.
Well, we're going to dissect a human. Wouldn't that be fun?
Let's dissect Daniel. I'm unkillable, though, so you can't do that.
Daniel, we don't have to kill you to dissect you.
Yeah, you do. You couldn't catch me even if I'm alive.
Once you know the answer to that, you can answer the answer.
There's this thing called Twitter.
Yeah,
that's what you're telling me.
what within your analogy, which is the same thing, to let's say the what's in your fridge?
Not
just
outside. You put it outside.
Yeah.
If it's bought, then maybe you
don't.
There you go.
All that. Does each part of this have to be labeled?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Let give that
more.
Not yet.
Help her sheet of paper around the side.
Okay, so like if I got paint.
Sure. Red one is this, the blue one is that. Yep, that
yeah,
works.
And remember, though, it's got to be both items, so you can't just put the organelle name. You also have to put the analogy name.
And what do you call that? You have that little document inside of it.
How big is
the
clue that you make
with
the
clue?
And
only allows people with proper
certification. One with the second one.
Or...
So we can eat anywhere from one.
There's a beta cell.
You get that one with lunch period? The high school?
The high school kids go back to use only 12 people. It's just like a small
circle.
You okay there?
Yeah.
You look
going insane.
Half good teas, you can just tell it.
No, food doesn't get digested within a fridge.
Oh,
Mr. Schneider, if I were to ask you what that gets digested within a fridge, what would you first go to?
Water.
I bet.
I know what I'm thinking.
We watch.
I don't think anything gets digested in a fridge.
Yeah, see, it does.
It's a good movie. Left us alone.
I never went there. That's actually not bad.
She don't get ground up in her food processor.
Dude, I trash.
They do.
Things get boiled and come apart on a stove.
I think of water within a fridge.
Also freeze
the either the ice cubes and or the defrost in the freezer.
Oh yeah.
It's not a true digestion because it's not being utilized as an energy source.
And if you're gonna say digesting, I might start thinking about the intestines and tubes and stuff, and there's freon in the tubes.
Oh, good call there. Good call.
Are you 486 now?
Sure, because if you don't have cool in your fridge, you actually have lost that stuff.
Yep.
Thus, it's been utilized to do its job.
You have the tubes that go up and down the back to cool off. Or
right. So
you get
water.
Rid of the heat, and then those tubes go inside your freezer and inside your refrigerator. You just don't see them.
Yeah.
Thanks, Mr. Schneider.
What
is
so what within a fridge uses things in order to create energy? Then I can get her analysis.
I know.
That's okay. Big bang. Energy within a fridge.
If I don't have another joke,
the lights don't
make
her.
They
emit.
They
don't care about
her.
I could care less about her.
I need to take this.
Have you ever got a phone call where somebody asks you if your fridge is running?
You better go catch it?
Yeah.
No.
How is your fridge running?
I've never had that.
The outlet doesn't run your fridge.
The
plug-in doesn't fight it.
No.
You're close. You're just... You're acting
the
like...
Guy
you're
the
house.
What's
his
name?
Westinghouse?
No,
what are you
talking
about?
I have a question for you.
Oh, the Ebert.
I'm at the freezer at the top.
Mr. Schneider.
Oh my goodness.
Franklin.
Mr.
Schneider.
Franklin.
What did he create?
Yeah,
there you go.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go to
no, Edison.
Yeah, we're not talking light bulb.
Oh,
you got a 9 on this side. That's not bad. We're 2-9. You know what, Jamin? Go to Cameron. This time you're only going to get 1 or 2. Yes.
I have a question.
Yes.
To having a product, if you need an explanation of your product.
I got the explanation.
All
right. Let's stop.
Okay.
Let's go.
Do you know what they do? In regular people work. I think that's the problem. If you can dumb that down for like a little guy and just explain it does this. 3-4 words. Then you can probably find a part of a football team or the coaches or the guys that run the
teams
or the guys that move something that's going on in the football field.
Like where
the
fridge and the refrigerator up and down?
Yes.
Okay.
You can stop taking
what are you doing?
You need to take that one for Sandy.
I have a question. Okay, so cocaine is made by ribosomes. And so in my analogy up here earlier, I said that the...
No, that's where I carved it.
Yeah,
so
like the smooth ER represents the workers because the ER carry ribosomes throughout the cell, which helps the cell function, just like the workers are trying to help the visitors when they go to the park.
Okay.
So if I already said that the ribosomes are the, like what the people, what the workers carry around, water, snacks.
Are you giving up air?
I can't figure out what is
produced
from the snacks.
From the snacks.
Yes, we can.
Struggling.
I haven't even had a same thing.
It's produced when people eat.
So sure.
But again, it's a plant. But so, well, with humans, right, it's going to be the energy. So that's the cells, right? What specifically is within a plant cell that comes out?
Do
you know what I mean? Yeah, which creates
sugars.
Construction camp. This is hard.
Are we making your brain hurt?
Awesome.
I don't know what to mess.
You have brains?
You do have brains.
What's the function in the cell? Whichever thing you're stuck in on. You're stuck in
the
cell.
What's
the function of the smooth ER?
I love driving bobcats.
Can't pull one in. Does it make them?
Oh my goodness, Jamin. You only got four wrong. You went from 22 wrong to four. You'll do again, did not? Can you do
it? Bobcats, right? I helped my grandfather.
Are you done with it?
I knew the job.
Think you're done with it. And then start chatting how she's got like, we're going to have these guys start putting up.
I drew them back.
Yeah,
you
can
shut
it down. I'll remember what I said. I would take
them. Aha! I figured a way out.
Back up.
Yeah, what was the thing with power sports? Can I get into
yeah,
that?
Yeah, I figured out
an archetype.
This was
so protein
was like a wildcat, though. It's an archetype here, right?
On
a
large scale.
It was a wildcat or something like that.
One,
we get to go
off. A micrometer equals 1/4 of an inch.
All right, wow.
Yeah,
James. They're protein.
It had
this is the
1 liter.
How much longer till class is over, guys?
Oh, like 10 minutes, Mrs. Keller? I think we're doing them to you.
Do I have time to make my little spiel really quick and share my screen?
Yep. Oh, like 6 minutes left until the bell rings, but yep, you've got the floor.
Awesome. Okay, can everybody see the screen here? Or is there a way we can project that up on the wall?
We cannot from here.
Shoot. Well, I can save it for next time. Would that be a better
idea?
Yeah, that wouldn't hurt anything.
Let's do that. So, guys, I don't know how many of you have seen your super plants grades and hopefully not freaked out too much. There's this thing called the design cycle that I know Mr. and Mrs. Schneider talk about a lot, where you are, I'm going to share my screen anyway, and if you can see, awesome, and if you can't, no worries. But the point of the design cycle is that this whole project-based learning stuff that you guys are doing in here is a process, that there is no final grade until your semester grades are in and done, right? Because quarter grades don't really count. How does it work in Ann Arbor?
They kind of do, but they kind of don't.
It does for honor roll and silly things like that, but that's it.
Okay. So quarter grades not as big of a deal. Semester grades, that's your final share product. That's going to be the end. So up until then, you can resubmit stuff, you can work on stuff, you can talk to Mr. Mrs. Schneider and to me about how you can improve certain grades of projects. Obviously, the longer it gets, like if you wait until the end of the semester and you go, oh, by the way, I'd like to improve my super plan, that's not such a good idea. But doing it now, like within, you know, the day, today, tomorrow, this weekend, just getting it, getting a handle on it would be sooner the better, basically. Although not too soon, because I want to talk to you on Monday.
That took me time, like, watching
Thursday. So, hold that thought. start working on it again. But there's, you know, identify the problem, brainstorm the problem, design the project, build the project, evaluate, modify, share. Okay, you guys are in the evaluate, modify process with this. By no means are your super plans done yet. You guys have gotten off to an awesome start, and I want to congratulate you on that. I was really impressed with a lot of the humor and creativity I saw in these. They made me giggle sometimes, and I love that when I'm creating things, but you guys can relate them back to the labs. That's the big thing, and we'll talk more about that on Monday. I just wanted to let you know not to freak out too much, and that you are in the evaluation modification stage right now. Cher will come hopefully Monday or Tuesday. Okay, that was a lot of verbal blah, blah, blah. Any questions or concerns right now?
Have you all seen your grades on the super plan?
No.
They're somewhere between 7 out of 70 and 50 out of 70?
No.
Mine says 65.
65? So there's one or two that are really good, and the rest of them are like really bad? Don't freak out. Make them better.
It's going to be Daniel's. We all know that already.
Daniel didn't get such a good grade on it either.
That's what I was saying.
Yeah. Sorry, Daniel.
And if you haven't turned it in, please get it in.
Yeah.
So that's three people still. One person, I think, probably thinks they turned it in.
Uh-oh.
Trevor.
Trevor.
You have Taco Burrito, too, and there's a picture of a tree, but you said everything else is in your lab notebook. Please take some snapshots of your lab notebook and upload that so I can see it.
Okay.
That would be awesome.
Thank
and,
you so much. And that is all. Color it out.
Color it out.
Have a good day, you guys.
Remember that our new kid wasn't here for that one?
Right, so she's not one of the three I counted.
Okay, I just didn't know if you'd forget that.
Right, no, we're not grading her on that since she is not here yet.
Awesome.
No, it's Parker, Trevor, and Isabel.
Why don't you put it up on the chemistry books up there? Yes.
I'll go talk to the other two.
Daniel got the rulers, so Daniel, you are responsible for the rulers.
You're on it?
Come to you, English class, we'll check.
Are we gonna be back down here?
No. We're upstairs for English.
What is the project due?
We'll talk to her in English.
Are we leaving our stuff in here?
No.
So still work on it until then?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
So where do we put this?
I don't remember. My text.